Roughage. Roughage is the indigestible portion of food. It consists of fruits, vegetables, and outer coats of seeds, which are very rich in roughage. What is the main function of roughage? How roughage is important for digestive system? Roughage enables the food move easily through the intestines. This is the main function of roughage. Now let's see the process of nutrition in humans. So the whole process of nutrition in humans regulate in 5 steps. Ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and egestion. So these are the 5 steps for the process of nutrition followed by different organs of the digestive system of humans, such as mouth, teeth, tongue, salivary glands, esophagus, stomach, small intestines, liver, pancreas, large intestine, rectum, and anus. These are all the organs which includes in digestive system of human body, which regulate the digestive system. So let's discuss all 5 steps of nutrition along with different important organs of digestive system of human. So let's start with the very first process, that is ingestion. Now what happens in this process? What is the definition of this process? The process of taking food, drink, or another substance into the body by swallowing or absorbing it is called as ingestion. When a part of a food enters into the mouth, chewed by the teeth, at the time, the tongue gives it the shape of a spherical mass, which is called as bolus. Then our tongue pushes this mass into the pharynx. This bolus is then swallowed by esophagus, and this process of pushing of food is known as ingestion. So now let's discuss the organs involved in the process of ingestion are mouth, teeth, tongue, and salivary glands. So let's see first mouth. So as we discussed, the process of ingestion starts when food taken into the mouth cavity. Mouth is bordered by upper and lower lips. Lips helps in closing the mouth while swallowing of food. So this is all about mouth. Then teeth. Based on different shapes and functions, human teeth are of 4 types: incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. So these are the 4 types of teeth. Incisors. Incisors are the 8 teeth in the front and center of our mouth. 4 on the top and 4 on the bottom. These are incisors. The function of incisor is we use them in biting and cutting of food. So this is the function of incisor. Then canines. Canines are one on either side of the incisors present in each jaw. They are pointed for tearing food. Tearing is the act of breaking a part of a material by force without the use of any kind of cutting tool. So what is the function of canines? Because they are pointed, that's why they used for tearing the food. These are the canines. Then premolars. Premolars are present after 2 on each side of canines in each jaw. So these are premolars. Premolars helps in crushing and grinding the food. After that, molars. So molars are the last 3 teeth on each side in each jaw. These are molars. They have broad, uneven surface for finer crushing and grinding. So first, primary crushing and grinding done by premolars, and final crushing and grinding is done by molars, which is present on each side of the each jaw. The last molar on each side of each jaw is called as wisdom tooth. Then another organ which is used in ingestion process is our tongue. Tongue is the fleshy muscular organ attached to the floor of the buccal cavity. Let's see the functions of tongue. First one is, tongue helps to manipulate or manage the food while eating. Secondly, we can tell the taste or experience the taste of food only because of tongue. Then tongue helps in mixing the watery secretions, that is saliva, with the food. So these are the main functions of tongue. After tongue, salivary glands. Salivary glands are those in which secretion of saliva occurs. Saliva is a fluid which containing water, salts and slimy mucus. What do you know about salivary glands? Many times when you eat anything or when you eat your most favorite food, you might have experienced that your mouth watering. What is the reason behind this? From where this water arises? The answer is, this is happens because of secretions of salivary glands. Secretion of saliva occurs in group of three salivary glands. Where? First gland is located. Where? First gland is located below the tongue. Second one is located at the base of the ear. And third one is located on the inner side of the angles of lower jaw. So these are the group of three salivary glands which secretes saliva. Now let's see the function of salivary glands. Functions of saliva. Now let's see the functions of saliva. Saliva moistens and lubricates the mouth so that one can swallow the food easily, and this moist mouth with the help of tongue also helps in speaking. Without moisture, your tongue never works. You would be unable to speak. So, this is the main important function of saliva. Then it acts as a solvent, which dissolves some part of the food to stimulate the taste. Saliva cleans the mouth and destroys germs. Saliva initiates the digestion by converting the salt into simple form of maltose. Let's take an example of bread and rice. Eat a small piece of bread or one bite of rice without salt and any flavor. Chewed thoroughly, you can feel this sweet taste only because of conversion of simple tasteless salt into sweet maltose. This is all happens only because of saliva with the help of enzyme, amylase and water. So this is all about the process of ingestion and the organs which is required or which includes the process of ingestion.